Hey, this is Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, we're still looking at financial ratios. Today, we're going to look at solvency ratios. Last week, I did liquidity ratios. A couple items before we start. One, there are other solvency ratios besides the three that I listed in rows 2, 3, and 4. Another item, and I get this question a lot, is after I show the liquidity ratios, what's the difference between a liquidity ratio versus a solvency ratio? It's pretty easy. The liquidity ratios that I did last week all have to do with the balance sheet, but they're all short-term within 1 year. We were looking at current assets and current liabilities. In this example, we're bringing in equity, but we're also looking at all assets, all liabilities, long-term, all of them. So this paints a broader picture for a company. And finally, let's not forget about our accounting formula. Assets equal liabilities plus owner's equity or stockholder's equity. So before I even start diving into all three of these, and we will look at these also with two different actual companies, and I'm going to show you some exercises in Excel. Real quick, here's a good example of this, especially that first one in row 2, the debt to equity ratio. Making this on a personal side, let's say as an example, you have a house, 3 cars, cash, investments, 401k, and your assets are $700,000. What you owe still on your house and your cars and other items, I'm making this number up, is $380,000. So assets minus your liabilities is your equity. So real quick here, the debt to equity ratio, you owe $380,000. Your equity is $320,000. So that is 1.1875. What that number is telling you is for every dollar of equity you have $1.19 of liability that you owe to somebody. The lower the number, the better. So let's assume that your neighbor also has a house and it's slightly bigger. You did a 15-year loan. They did 30. They have an additional car, and all their cars are real high-end, Mercedes, BMW. So they have $850,000 in assets, but their liabilities total $650,000. Your number was 1.1875. Their number is 3.25. The lower the number, again, the better. So let's go and pop over here and take a look at three fictitious companies I made up. Assets equal liabilities plus stockholders' equity. I copied and pasted also the three different solvency ratios and the formula over here. So the debt to equity ratio is the total liabilities divided by the stockholders' equity. Debt ratio is total debt divided by your assets. So 300,000 divided by 500,000. And then the opposite of that one, because we're still using assets, is my stockholders' equity divided by the assets. So those two numbers in row 8 and 9 should equal 100%, and they do. So I'm going to highlight these three and pull them over, and then we'll talk about them. So looking at these numbers, the company in column B and the company in column D, even though they have a lot less assets, to compare to the DEF company. Someone says, oh, DEF, they got $1,000 in assets. Their assets are financed by their liabilities. So notice it's a high percentage, 760 into the 1,000 right there. So they don't have a lot of owner's equity or stockholder's equity. One other item I want to mention is you can't use just these three financial ratios alone if you're deciding whether you're going to buy stock in some company or not. There are 20, 30, there's a lot of financial ratios you need to look at. Let's go now to look at Microsoft's debt to equity ratio, and then let's pull up another company. We'll figure it out when we get there. So I went to one of my favorite sites, thewallstreetjournal.com. click over here. Let's type in Microsoft. Actually, I've already typed it in. I typed in Microsoft right here. I'll just show you real quick. Typed in Microsoft and there it was, and it pulled it up. Microsoft Corporation. Couple easy financial metrics right here, but here's your financials. All solvency ratios that I'm doing today are based on the balance sheet. There are other solvency ratios based on the income statement too. So let's go here. Here's our assets. The years at the top, 2018 through 2022. And if I scroll to the bottom, total assets, 364. Assets equal liability plus owner equity. So if I expand liabilities and owner stockholders equity, I should get 364. I'm just going to go check that number real quick and it's right. And here we go. Here are their liabilities. I'm going to copy this number. Here is total equity. I'm going to copy that number right there. Pop back into Excel. Just to keep this simple, I'm going to paste them. There we go. Total liabilities divided by total stockholders' equity. Microsoft's at 1.19. For every dollar of equity, they have $1.19 of liabilities. Really good number, by the way. The lower the number, the better. When you start doing these, you would compare Microsoft to someone else in their industry. You'd compare Home Depot to Lowe's, to Ace Hardware. Those would all be a comparison. If I'm looking at Marriott, I'll compare Marriott to Hilton, IHG. So let's just go pull up Marriott to see what they're doing. Same steps, financials, balance sheet. Last one, by the way. Total assets, 25,553. This should be 25,553. Perfect. Liabilities. Wow, that's up there. It's all right though. Equity. Copy. There is Marriott at 17.07. For every $1 of equity, they've got $17 of liabilities. Again, I can't tell you whether to invest in either one of these companies. That's up to you. But you do need to look at other financial ratios besides just solvency ratios. But these are great ratios. Hope you enjoyed this. Appreciate your time. If you have any comments or questions or suggestions, throw them down below. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.